Hello everyone, this is Reham Alqaimary. Welcome to our English class for 7th grade. Today in this video, I will answer with you some of the reading comprehension questions in our student book, page 20, and in our workbook, page 12. Let's start with question number 1 in our student's book, page 20. Choose the best words to complete the sentences. Number 1. Philip's cousin was a newspaper. A. Reporter. B. Seller. Or C. Reader. Philip's cousin was a newspaper seller. ابن عم Philip كان بائع صحف. 2. The bus fumes mixed with the scent of A. Oil. B. Flowers. Or C. Roses. The bus fumes mixed with the scent of flowers. أبخرت أو غازات. الحافلة اختلطت وامتزجت برائحة الأزهار. 3. The thief was difficult to A. Recognize. B. Watch. Or C. Notice. The thief was difficult to recognize. كان من الصعب إدراك ومعرفة اللص. 4. The square was famous for A. The statues. B. The pool. Or C. The fountain. The square was famous for the fountain. كانت الساحة مشهورة بالنافورة. 5. The fountain was made from A. A white marble. B. White ice. Or C. Arctic ice. The fountain was made from white marble. كانت النافورة مصنوعة من الرخام الأبيض. 6. The thief was interested in A. Photography. B. The bank. Or C. The buildings. The thief was interested in the bank. كان اللص مهتم بالبنك. 7. The tourists hurried away towards A. Their bus. B. The bank. Or C. The main street. The tourists hurried away towards their bus. أسرع السياح باتجاه حافلتهم. 8. The thief was suddenly A. Hidden. B. Gun. Or C. Alone. The thief was suddenly alone. كان اللص فجأة وحيدا. Question number 3. Read these sentences from the story. Underline all the adjectives. Here you have to underline the adjectives in these sentences يا سابع. يجب أن نضع خط تحت الصفات الموجودة في هذه الجمل. It had 6 white columns at the front. 6 and white are adjectives. You have to underline it. Broad steps led up to the massive wooden doors, and a blue and gold flag was flying above the vast entrance. Here we have a broad is an adjective, massive is an adjective, wooden, blue, gold, and vast. All of these are adjectives you have to underline. Now do the following tasks. 1. Rewrite the sentences, leave out all the adjectives. يجب أن تعيد كتابة هذه الجمل بدون استخدام أو كتابة هذه الصفات. Number 2. Read the sentences. Does the description of the building sound different and how? 7. بعد ما كتبنا الجمل بدون استخدام هذه الصفات. Does the description of the building sound different? هل وصف البناء رح يبدو مختلف؟ وكيف؟ Of course يا 7. The description without the adjectives does not tell the reader about the large size of the building and does not suggest that it is important and special. بدون أنا ما أستخدم الصفات تمام ما رح أقدر إني أعرف حجم البناء الحقيقي وقد هو كبير. And it is or does not suggest that it is important and special. أنا ما هعرف قد إيه أهمية هذا البناء وقد إيه هو له خصوصيته صح؟ So the adjectives in our text is very important. أهمية الصفات ما بنقدر إننا ننكرها وهي كتير مهمة وبتعطيك تفاصيل أكتر تمام بتعطيني تفاصيل أكتر عن وصف أي شيء أنا بدي أحكي عنه. Number 3. Find two adjectives in the sentences that mean almost the same. What do they mean? يجب أن أستخرج من هدول الجمل يا سابع يجب أني أستخرج صفتين بيعطوني نفس المعنى. What do they mean؟ وإيش معناهم هون ورد بالنص. Here we have the two adjectives massive and vast. These two adjectives means very big. massive يا سابع و vast نفس المعنى بيعطوني معنى very big كبير جدا. Question number 4. Scan the text and find. You have to find from the text. Number 1. 5 things that were being sold in the square. بدنا نستخرج هون يا سابع 5 أشياء بتنباع في الساحة حسب النص. Number 1. Newspapers. صحف. Cold drinks. مشروبات باردة. Snacks. وجبات خفيفة. Ice creams. اللي هي المثلجات. Flowers. الأزهار. Number 2. Find out 4 things that the tourists were doing. بدنا كمان يا سابع هون 5 أشياء السياح كانوا عم يعملوها. Number 1. Chatting. كانوا عم يحكوا مع بعض. 2. Laughing. كانوا عم بيضحكوا مع بعض. Taking photos. كانوا عم ياخذوا بيلتقطوا صور. Number 4. Throwing seeds to the pigeons. كانوا عم يرموا البذور ل أو الحبوب للحمام. 3 animals. ثلاث حيوانات from the text. Fish. السمك. Horses. الأحصنة. 3 pigeons. الحمام. Number 4. 3 vehicles. ثلاث مركبات. Number 1. Bus. Chariot and cart. Chariot and cart يا سابع means عربة. Cart is smaller than chariot. Chariot we use it for war, للحرب. عربات حربية. Cart for shopping, for selling things. That's all about our questions in the student's book page 20. Now let's move to the workbook page 12. Question number 1 in this page. Read the man at the fountain again. Here we have to read our text in the student's book. Question number 2. Complete the sentences from the text, the man at the fountain. Number 1. The square was on this hot afternoon. The square was bustling on this hot afternoon. Number 2, buses with windows were cruising around the square. Buses with dusty windows. Dusty windows here means النوافذ المغبرة. Number 3, blue-gray fumes rose into the air. غازات أو أبخرة زرقاء رمادية ارتفعت في الهواء. Number 4. He was almost hidden by a group of tourists with clicking cameras. هو كان مختبئ بواسطة مجموعة من السياح الذين كانوا يلتقطوا بعض الصور بالكاميرات. 5. It was made from the white marble and glistened like arctic ice. Glistened here means لامع. كانت مصنوعة من الرخام الأبيض. That glistened like arctic ice. كان يلمع مثل جليد القطب الشمالي. 6. He took several photos of the square. أخذ أو التقط صور عديدة للساحة. 7. It had 6 white columns at the front. 6 أعمدة. كان فيه أو موجود فيه 6 أعمدة في المقدمة في الأمام. 8. It used to belong to a dock. كان يعود إلى الدوق. 9. Philip frowned and stared harder at the man. كان فيليب يحدق بشدة إلى الرجل وهو اللص. 10. Startled pigeons took off in a cloud of gray. Pigeons here means الحمام. Now let's move to question number 3. Answer these questions. Use short answers. Here we have to answer these questions according to the text in our student book. 1. How did Philip know that the man was a thief? كيف عرف Philip أن هذا الرجل هو لص? Because his picture was in the newspapers. لأن صوره كانت في الصحف. 2. What things were being sold in the square? ما هي الأشياء التي كانت تباع في الساحة؟ Newspapers, cold drinks, snacks, flowers, and ice creams. الصحف، المشروبات الباردة، الوجبات الخفيفة، الأزهار والمثلجات. 3. Where did the buses stop? أين توقفت الحافلات؟ Under the trees، تحت الأشجار. 4. Why was the thief difficult to recognize? لماذا كان من الصعب إدراك اللص ومعرفته؟ He was in disguise، كان متنكرا. 5. Which people were looking for the man? من هم الناس اللي كانوا يبحثوا عن الرجل؟ The police، الشرطة. 6. Which people were almost hiding the thief? من هم الناس اللي كانوا دائما يختبئ بواسطتهم اللص؟ The tourists، السياح. Number 7. What were in the four corners of the fountain? ماذا كان يوجد في الزوايا الأربعة للنافورة؟ Huge leaping fish، سمكة أو أسماك ضخمة. 8. Who called out to Philip؟ من نادى على فيليب؟ His cousin، ابن عمه. 9. Who used to own the elegant building؟ من كان معتاد على استخدام البناء الأنيق؟ الدوق. 10. Why could Philip not see the thief after the tourists left؟ لماذا لم يستطيع فيليب أن يرى اللص بعد مغادرة السياح؟ An ice cream seller pushed his cart and stopped in front of the fountain. لأن بائع الآيس كريم pushed his cart، دفع عربته وتوقف في أمام النافورة. Question number 4. Answer these questions. Check your answer with the text. If the text does not tell you the answer, write I can tell. يجب أن نجيب على هذه الأسئلة. إذا الإجابة ما كانت موجودة بالنص، we have to write I can tell. Question number 1. Who was Philip waiting for? من كان ينتظر فيليب؟ He was waiting for his cousin. كان ينتظر ابن عمه. 2. What was his cousin doing? ماذا كان يفعل ابن عمه؟ He was selling a newspaper. كان يبيع الصحف. 3. Where were they going to go together? أين سيذهبان معا؟ They were going to a match، إلى المباراة. 4. Did they go to the match؟ هل ذهبا إلى المباراة؟ Here we have to write I can't tell. The text does not tell us the answer. 5. Did Philip plan to follow the thief؟ هل خطط فيليب لي أن يتبع اللص؟ Yes, he did. 6. Did Philip follow the thief؟ هل تبع فيليب اللص؟ Here we can't tell because the answer or the text does not tell us the answer. That's all about our questions in the workbook page 12. I hope that everything is clear for you. Thanks for listening.